So there's a lot of dealers, I think it was 44% in your presentation today, that are not following up on customers that they've been in contact with before. I mean, what should they be doing?
Yeah, this concerns me hugely, and tracking back, it's been the same sort of figures for many years now. 44% of dealers simply do not follow up people who've bought used cars. They need to do that. They need to be farming the market, which is a phrase I like. If you're farming a market, it means you've got to put fertiliser on it, you've got to plant things in it. You've got to manage your used car market in the same way. It's much easier to retain your current business than it is to go out and search for new business. So I think dealers need to put a lot more effort in that. As we heard from other presentations, the market is going to become tighter and tougher. We put a lot of effort into CRM, customer relation management programs. To be honest, I see a lot of those as being elastoplasts rather than good belt and braces customer relationship.
Sure. Okay. So how about kind of the size of the market and what's going to happen with that? Can you talk about that?
Yeah. It's interesting looking at the comparison between the new car market and the used car market. In 2009, we reckon that the used car market was about just over £6 billion more than the new car market. When you think about it, a dealer normally can make a better margin on a used vehicle than they can on a new one. Hey guys, are you really looking to develop that market? Have you got your share of it? Should you be looking to build more penetration in that market sector? And I think that with the way that we're seeing new car sales forecasts over the next few years, that issue is going to continue. And I can well see this year that the used car market will be, the difference between the used car market and the new car market will be even bigger than that $6 billion that we saw last year.
Yeah, sure. How about, can you talk about, there's a part in your presentation where you spoke about targeting and kind of going after the right kind of customers and then reflecting that with the kind of stock that you acquire.
Yeah. It's interesting when one analyses the market. We've done it, and it's shown in the report, where we've broken it down by sex, we've also broken it down by age group. The very, very distinct age groups, those age groups are moving. I think that if one looks at it, one can target, from a dealership point of view, certain groups. For example, students, young people, okay, they're hard up in terms of money, but if they're going to college, if they're going to university, very often they're going to live at home. But they will need transport. Well, if they've got paying for the car, then they will look to trade the car in after, let's say, 6 months, because it's on call to keep the same car the whole time. And mum and dad will make sure they have a good one. And of course, once they finish their courses, then at some stage those people are going to be potential new car buyers. And if they've had a good ongoing relationship with you, then there you are, they're set up.